Hello and welcome to another Lumbridge Night Guide for free-to-play old school RuneScape. In this guide, we're going to be going through everything to do with the hill giant boss, Obor. So, fee-fi-fo-fum, I reckon you don't want to miss this one. I think that rhymed. Why then should you fight Obor? Challenge to kill him is obviously worth pursuing, and if you kill him enough times, you can land yourself on the coveted OSRS high scoreboard. The current number one is something like 4,500 kills, so you know, if you start now, you might be done by sometime next century. Obor also has 6 combat achievements that you can unlock by defeating him in various ways, but I'm not going to cover them in this particular guide. Obviously, the main reason is to do with drops. In general, Obor has 2 key drops. The first one is the Hill Giant Club. This is a high strength item on par with the Rune 2-hander, dealing the most damage in terms of crush. It's quite rare and has a 1 in 118 chance of dropping. The second item of interest is the Rune Kite Shield. This, as far as I'm aware, is the only way that Ironmen can obtain a Rune Kite Shield other than a smith one themselves. And Obor also drops a variety of other rune drops, gems, magic runes, and other items of varying rarity and cost. This is courtesy of OSRS Wiki. Awesome source, always check them out. Let's look at Obor's stats. You can see them popping up on the screen in general, I'm not going to go through every single one, but he has 120 health, a max melee hit of 22, and a maxed range hit of 28. Obor does not attack with magic, and as you can see from his defensive stats, he is more susceptible to magic and range. However, in free-to-play, the ranged equipment available just isn't good enough to fight Obor. We're going to discount range straight away. Magic is only pursuable in free-to-play if you use Snare in order to immobilize him, which obviously leaves melee as the other option. How do we access Obor? Well, his lair is located within the Edgeville dungeon. You'll be seeing a map on the screen of how to get there, as well as the route to his lair. In order to open the gate to his lair, you will need giant keys, which are dropped by hill giants. So you'll probably need to kill a fair few hill giants in order to obtain some giant keys to unlock the instance and fight Obor in the first place. If you haven't got your brass key for quick access to the Edgeville dungeon, make sure you pick one up. It's just useful to have. Fighting hill giants then, there's 2 main spawns in free to play. One is in the wilderness. I think these guys are around the lava maze somewhere. There's a 1 in 64 chance of obtaining a key if you fight hill giants in the wilderness. So for non-Iron Men or for regular Iron Men, maybe if you're willing to take the risk, this is a good option. However, there's only around 6 that actually spawn in the wilderness versus the 12 or so in the Edgeville dungeon, so they're much more readily available within the Edgeville dungeon. And then obviously that's right next to the instance and also reasonably close to the Varrock West Bank. These, however, will have the 1 in 128 chance of getting a key, so you'll probably have to kill significantly more hill giants. And also, on that note, you might want to check out my magic training guide, a link to which will be popping up on the screen now, as this utilises hill giants in the training. Once we've got enough keys, you're going to have to decide which technique you're going to use, magic or melee. Don't worry, I'll give you both, and each has its own stats, items, and equipment that you will need in order to be successful when fighting Obor. We're going to go through magic first, since it's a bit more involved. So we'll start with the stats you're going to need. You're going to need a minimum of 40 prayer. This is to utilize the Protect from Missiles prayer. This is crucial because it halves the amount of ranged damage that Obor's ranged attack deals. And trust me, I've trialed both Protect from Melee and Protect from Missiles. Okay, next up, you're going to need 50 magic, and I personally recommend a defense level of 50 as well. Some people might say this is a little bit high, but this is just on the off chance that you do take hits from Obor. You probably want to have that little bit extra defense. It might be a bit overkill, but I personally would edge on the side of caution. Moving on to equipment next then, you should be seeing a breakdown of my recommended minimum equipment required for battling Obor using magic. For each, I've provided an estimated cost based on the current GE price. So finally, items. You should once again be able to see a breakdown of my recommendations on the screen now, along with approximate price guides. Obviously, as we'll be using magic, you need to make sure you bring an appropriate magic staff, allowing you to auto cast blast spells and runes to go with both the blast spells and obviously snare, since our whole tactic is going to revolve around casting snare. And that covers basically the stats, equipment, and items. Moving on to the actual battle tactics associated with fighting Obor. Just before you enter the instance, I've created this handy checklist to ensure that, you know, you've checked health, prayer, run, blah, blah, blah. You get the idea. So check that you have successfully completed the checklist before going through the door. Once you enter the instance, don't worry about being instantly attacked when you reach the other side. Obor is in this little pit and he will not attack you until you descend into the pit. What you probably want to do is wait until Obor is at one side of the pit or the other. You'll see that highlighted roughly on the screen there. And when he's in any of these positions, descend into the pit and instantly hit him with a snare. You're probably better off activating your Protect from Missiles before you actually descend into the pit. So once you're in the pit with the prayer activated and you've hit him with a snare, run to the opposite side and just start spanking him up with blast spells. In this case, we're going to be using Water Blast. Snare lasts for 9.6 seconds, otherwise known as 5 ticks. So you've roughly got around one attack before he'll start moving again. Obviously, this is minus your running time. I recommend you try to hit him with one or two blast spells and then follow that up with a snare, trying to pin him at the opposite end as far away from you as possible. When he gets close enough, you probably want to snare him and run to the opposite end again and just rinse and repeat. Keep doing this snare, blast spells, snare, blast spells, and just keep rinsing and repeat until he is one down. Remember, if you need to use some of your energy potion to make sure you've got enough run energy to run past him. Keep this up and eventually, as you should have just seen on the screen, he will be defeated. And that pretty much sums up how to kill Obor using magic.
Please like the video and support my content. Thank you, noble knight.
Now let's look at the other option of using a melee sort of tanked option, and we're going to get straight into the stats, equipment, and items required. So the stats are kind of similar to before in that obviously you're going to need 40 prayer again. It doesn't matter how you approach Obor, defense from missiles is the boyo, and I recommend base stats of around 50. So just in case you're wondering, that's 50 attack, 50 strength, and 50 defense. If you have these stats, you should be in with a good chance of killing Obor if you have the right equipment, which we're going to look at next. As you saw in the previous step, you should now be able to see a breakdown of the recommended melee equipment along with approximate price guides. There's no real tips or tricks to this other than to bring the best possible melee equipment you can afford. You'll see in the videos throughout that I use Rune Full Plate. Actually, Rune Chain Body is superior since Obor attacks with Crush, which also means you don't need to have completed the Dragon Slayer 1 quest. In terms of weapons, regular players are still best off with the Rune Scimitar, and Ironman, you are best off with the Rune Sword, not the Rune Longsword. You'll do more damage with the Rune Sword, as Obor is slightly more susceptible to stabbing than he is Crush. That's why we don't want to use the Baronite Mace here, and the speed of the standard Rune Sword is faster than that of the Rune Longsword, so you'll do higher DPS with the Rune Sword. Ironman, if you can't get the Amulet of Power, go for the Amulet of Strength. Obviously, again, that's level 50 crafting, so if you can't hit that, go for the Amulet of Accuracy available from the Imp Catcher quest. And on to items. You should be able to see a breakdown of my recommended items along with their approximated costs. The only real difference in terms of items between this method and the last method is the addition of a strength pot to increase your melee max hit and the lack of runes, so we'll be carrying a bit more food. And finally, the melee battle tactics. Once again, before you enter the instance, do the checklist. So is your prayer recharged? Do you have full health? Etc, etc, you know the drill. So if you pass all those checks, then Thunderbirds are go. Let's enter the instance. The only trick to fighting Obor using melee is to ensure that Obor pins you against the wall. I'm going through the grid squares on the screen there of where you kind of want to be and where you want Obor to be. You want to wait till Obor's close to the entrance to the pit. The closer he is, ideally right at the bottom, the better. And you want to then activate your defense from missiles, climb down the pit and run to Obor as soon as possible, and make sure that you are orientated as close to the nearest wall as possible with Obor positioned so that he's essentially pinning you against the wall. The reason you want to do this is because Obor has a slam attack, which he can use to knock you back. Now, if you're against the wall, this at least eliminates the knockback effect so that you don't go flying back three or four squares or however it is and lose that time. You will, however, still have a slight delay to your next attack, whether you're against the wall or not. But at least if you're pinned, it saves you having to run back and keeps you just focused on the minimum number of clicks. You just have to compensate for damage by eating food. So with Protect from Missiles active, you're pinned against the wall now, and you're using the correct slash or stab attack style based off your weapon of choice. Simply grind him down until he is dead. You will have to keep clicking on the food and compensating for the damage he's going to do to you, because he will hit quite high. If you are low level in prayer or your prayer gets too low, remember you can use prayer flicking to ensure that your prayer stays up for the majority of the battle. This will help you avoid taking too much damage and just generally be careful. And obviously, if things go wrong, do not be afraid to teleport out. Obviously, you lose that instance, but you know, you live to fight another day. And that pretty much sums up melee in a nutshell. Now, as with all my videos, I like to bring a couple of bonus tips right at the end. So here are some key tips that will make fighting Obor that little bit easier. The first tip is to always recharge your prayer at the monastery to the west of Edgeville. The reason you want to do this is because it gives you 2 extra prayer points. You do need 31 prayer in order to access the altar at the monastery, but obviously if you've listened to my advice, you should be level 40, so this shouldn't be a problem. The second tip I'm going to bring to you is to go into your settings and under the control tab, as you can see I'm doing on the screen there for you, and where it says NPCs, change the option to left click where available. Normally for high level NPCs such as Obor being level 106, you'd have to right click and then left click to attack. Changing this option, as I've suggested, allows you to attack with one left click instead of the normal right click left click combo. This is crucial when you want to eat, flick your prayer, and or anything in between, move, etc., allowing you to resume the attack with one simple left click. The third tip is to do with setting up your quick prayers. To set up your quick prayers, all you need to do is right click on the quick prayer icon next to your minimap. So right click, set up quick prayers, and in this instance, we want to be using Protect from Missiles. Once that is done, we want to come off that menu, and now we can toggle our prayers on and off by simply clicking this icon on the screen, as you can see my character doing. This is critical if you want to perform prayer flicking, which is my fourth tip. To give a detailed explanation of prayer flicking against Obor, I use an online metronome. If you just search for metronome on Google, you can get that and set it to 100 beats per minute. This is roughly aligned to the game clock. Since Obor has an attack speed of 6, this means he generally attacks on the 6th tick. I can align that now, and I'll tune the metronome in so you can hear it. So that basically I click the prayer on the 4th or 5th tick and turn it off again on the 6th or just after the 6th. This basically preserves my prayer and allows me to have all the benefit while not actually using it. The final tip I've got is to make sure you're using the hotkeys. In this case, I'm using F1 for my inventory and F2 for my spellbook. This allows me to jump back and forth so I can heal and cast snare as required. And then, assuming I've set up correctly based off my previous tip, I can just use a single left mouse click to resume attacking Obor. This is good for bossing, but also useful for RuneScape in general. And that pretty much sums up this video. I hope that it has been of some use to you. Thank you for watching, and if you have any tips or tricks to get the better of Obor, please leave a comment and let me know. I am eager to hear them. And this is the Lumbridge Knight saying peace out, guys.